So we have to find the distance of a point from a line. Let us suppose that we are having this line L. From this line, we are to find the distance of this point. So let the coordinates of this point be x1, y1. And the equation of this line, let us write it in the standard form, ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This is the equation of this line, ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Let this point be P, whose coordinates we are given x1, y1. We are to find the distance of P from this line L. Now for finding out the distance, D is equal to, since you know that the distance is always positive, so you are to put the modulus sign over here. So what we will do, we will simply put these coordinates of this point x1, y1 in place of x and y in the equation of the line. So this will be ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under the root, the coefficients of x and y, inke squares plus kar dene hai humne, a square plus b square. This value will again be positive. So the distance is ax1 plus by1 plus c modulus upon root a square plus b square, or you can say a square plus b square under the root. So your question number 4 is based on this formula. See the question 4 of exercise 10.3. Find the distance of the point. Now the point we are given minus 1 comma 1. This is question number 4, exercise 10.3. Find the distance of the point minus 1 comma 1 from the line, and the line we are given 12 into x plus 6, 12 into x plus 6 is equal to 5 into y minus 2, 5 into y minus 2. This line we are to find the distance of this line from this point P. So simply we will use this formula, but before using this formula, we are to write down this equation in the standard form. We will write down it in the form of AX plus BY plus C equal to 0. So let's open the brackets. 12X plus 72 is equal to 5Y minus 10. Bring all the terms to the left hand side. So we will be having 12X plus 72 minus 5Y plus 10 is equal to 0. So here we will be having 12x minus 5y plus 82 is equal to 0. So this is the standard equation of the line. Now this is of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Now we are to find the distance of this line from this point minus 1 comma 1. So let this point be x1 comma y1. Now we know distance of a point from a line we can find out by ax1 plus by1 plus c modulus upon root a square plus b square. So using this, we will be having distance is equal to ax1. A is 12 over here, x1 is minus 1. So we are having 12 into minus 1. Then plus. In place of B, we are having minus 5. So here we will write down minus 5 into, in place of Y1, we are having 1. So we will write down 1. So this is AX1 plus BY1. B jo hai, that was minus 5. So here we have used the negative sign. Plus C. In place of C, we are having 82. So 82 as it is. Upon, under the root, a square, a is 12, so 12 square plus minus 5 square. A square plus b square. Now simplify this. 12 into minus 1 is minus 12. Minus 5 into 1 is minus 5 plus 82 upon, this is 144 plus 25. Now again simplify this. We know that root 144 plus 25, that is 169 under the root. So this is minus 12 minus 5. This is minus 17 plus 82. This is 65 upon root 169. So this modulus will make it positive. Already it was positive because we were having the sign of the bigger number as positive. So this was plus 65, modulus again will make it positive. Already it was positive. So we are having 65 by 13. So that is 5 answer. Now since this is representing the distance, so you will write down over here 5 units. Because we don't know the unit, that whether it is in meters or centimeters. So we will write down simply 5 units. So the distance of the point minus 1 comma 1 from this line is 5 units. So this was your question number 4. See this question once again. We are to find the distance of the point minus 1 comma 1 from the given line. First of all, we will write down the given line in the standard form. Open the brackets, bring all the terms to the left hand side. Here we have got this of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Then we know the distance of a point from a line is given by this formula. So we have used the formula over here. A jo tha, that was 12, x1 was minus 1, b was minus 5, y1 was 1. So 12 into minus 1, minus 5 into 1, plus c, this is written as it is. Then enclosed in the modulus sign upon a square plus b square. B was minus 5 over here. So we have written here minus 5 whole square. Don't forget to put this in the bracket. Then simplify and you will get your answer. And whatever answer you will get, you are to write down units word in front of that. Find the points on the x-axis whose distances from the line x by 3 plus y by 4 equal to 1 are 4 units. We are to find the point on the x-axis. Now, since the point lies on the x-axis, so let us assume that the point is of the form h, 0. Let the point h, 0 lies on x-axis. You know that every point has the y-coordinate as 0, which is lying on the x-axis. So let the h, 0 be the point that is lying on the x-axis. Now we are given whose distance from the line x upon 3 plus y upon 4. Now this its distance from the line x by 3 plus y upon 4 is equal to 1. Now this is given to be 4 units. This distance is given, distance of this point from this line is given 4 units. Now, again, we are given the distance. So what we will do, first of all, we will write down in the standard form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Then we will use the formula for finding the distance of a point from a given line. So let's convert this to the standard form. 3 and 4, both are having no factor as common. So their LCM will be their product. 3 fours are 12. So this will get cross multiplied as their HCF is 1. So 4x plus 3y equal to 1. Now this 12 will get multiplied on this side. So this is 4x plus 3y is equal to 12. So this is the standard equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Now this c is on the right hand side. We are to bring it to the left hand side. So what we will do, bring 12 to the left hand side, this will become minus 12 and this is the equation. Now finding out the distance of this point from this line. Now distance of h, 0 from 4x plus 3y minus 12 equal to 0 is given by d is equal to modulus ax1. A is 4. X1 is h plus by1. Y1 is 0. Let this be x1 and y1. So a into x1 is h plus b into y1 is 0 minus 12. And this is divided by root a square plus b square. So a is 4 over here. So 4 square and b is 3. So this is 3 square. And what we are given? We are given this distance to be 4 units. This is given to be 4 units. So this d we will replace by 4. So we are having here 4 is equal to, this is 4 into h is 4h, 3 into 0 is 0, and 0 added to some number is that number only. So 4h plus 0 I have replaced with 4h, then minus 12 as it is, and then upon 4 square is 16 plus 3 square is 9. 16 plus 9 is 25. So this is root 25, and root 25 you know is 5. Now this 5 will go to this side. 20 is equal to 4h minus 12 modulus. Now you are to take care of one thing. Whenever you are having this modulus sign over here, and you are to remove this sign. जब ये modulus का sign हम remove करते हैं, on this side along with the constant we use plus minus, because ये value आपकी, अगर हम modulus हटा रहे हैं, this can be positive as well as negative. जब तक तो modulus लगा है, this value will always be positive. So this is plus 20. Now when we will remove this modulus sign, so we will be having 4h minus 12. Now the value of h, on this value of h, the value of this is based. It can be plus 20 or minus 20. So just you have to remember this. जब आप ये modulus का sign जो है हटाओगे, तो यहाँ जो आपकी value होगी, उसके साथ plus या minus का sign आप लगा लोगे. So now you will simplify by taking one time plus 20 and the other time minus 20. So let's complete this. Having this 4h minus 12 is equal to plus minus 20. A is equal to B. I have written in the form of B equal to A. So one time I have to take the positive value, and the other time I have to take the negative value. So 4h is equal to 32, h is equal to 8, and in this case 4h is equal to minus 20 plus 12, that is minus 8, and here h is equal to minus 2. So aapke paas ab h ki do values aa gayi hain. So the required points are, we were having which point? H comma 0. So simply put the value, required points are either 8 comma 0 or minus 2 comma 0. This is your answer, because we have got two values of h, so we will be having two points. Yani ki if I find out the distance of this line from 8 comma 0, then it will be 4, and if I find the distance of this line 4x plus 3y equal to 12 from minus 2 comma 0, then also it will be having a distance of 4 units. So this was your question number 5. So for finding the distance between two parallel lines. Now since the lines are parallel, so their slopes will be equal. Parallel lines will be having the same slopes. So let, if the line I am having is AX plus BY plus C1 equal to 0. Let this be the first line. Now since the slope of both the lines is same, therefore the other line will also be of the form AX plus BY plus this constant will be different. So these two lines are parallel. AX plus BY plus C1 equal to 0. Here also AX plus BY plus C2 equal to 0. Now you will notice that between the parallel lines, this part is same. Whenever the lines are parallel, this part, this x and y part, these terms will be same. Ax plus by, ax plus by. A coefficient here, it is of x coefficient. Here also, x coefficient will be a. If b, coefficient of y over here is b, here also the coefficient of y will be b. And even the signs will also be same. Then only they will be having the same slopes. But this constant value will be different. So this is c1 and c2. Now for finding the distance between the parallel lines, same formula, but in place of AX1 plus BY1 plus C, we will write down here, we will find out the difference between these constants, C1 minus C2. So this is modulus of, again, because this is representing the distance, so we are to take the positive value. So d is equal to modulus of c1 minus c2 upon same value as we were having in the previous formula, a square plus b square under the root. So this is the formula for finding out the distance between the two parallel lines. Now your question number 6 is based on this. In question number 6, we are having first equation is 15x plus 8y minus 34 equal to 0. 15x plus 8y minus 34 is equal to 0. And the second equation is again 15x plus 8y plus 31 equal to 0. These first two terms will be same as the lines are parallel to each other. So these two terms are same in both the lines. Now we are to find the distance between these lines. So what we are to do, we are to use this formula. So distance between the lines is given by c1 minus c2, yani ki minus 34 minus 31 plus, yahan pe waise ye minus into plus 31 aana tha, minus into plus is minus, divided by again same thing, a square plus b square. Now, minus 34 and minus 31, that is minus 65. And you are to find the square root of this. This is 15 square is 225 plus this is 8 square 64. This is 289. So in the next step, I'm removing this modulus sign. So this negative value will become positive. Absolute value of minus 65 we will take. This is 65 divided by 225 plus 64. 225 plus 64 is 289. So this is 65 upon 17. 65 upon 17. This is the square root of 289 is 17. So we are having 65 upon 17. Now there is no common factor between 65 and 17. So you will write down units in the answer. So distance between these two parallel lines is 65 upon 17 units. So this was your question number 6. Now in question number 7, we are having find the equation of the line parallel to the line 3x minus 4y plus 2 equal to 0. We are given this line 3x minus 4y plus 2 equal to 0. We are to find the equation of a line which is parallel to this. Iske parallel line ki hum equation nikalni hai. So now only I have told you for finding out the parallel line. So any line, let this be your line number 1. Any line parallel to line 1 will be of the form. Now, since the lines are parallel, so the first two terms will be same. So, will be of the form 3x minus 4y. Now, this constant will get changed. Now, I don't know ki is constant ki value kya hai. So, let me take this as k. So, the required line will be 3x minus 4y plus k equal to 0. So, this line will be parallel to this line. Whenever the lines are parallel, you know that the slopes are equal. So therefore, if this line is given to me, so parallel line will be of the form 3x minus 4y plus k equal to 0. Now, the second condition you are given that this is passing through the point minus 2 comma 3. This parallel line is passing through minus 2 comma 3. It means minus 2 comma 3 lies on this line. And since minus 2 comma 3 lies on this line, so that will satisfy its equation. Let this be line number 2. Now, we are given minus 2 comma 3 lies on line 2. So it will satisfy equation of line 2. Now we will put the values of these points in this equation and we will get the value of k. So therefore 3 into minus 2 plus 3 into minus 2 minus 4 into this is 3 plus k is equal to 0. this is minus 6, 4 threes are 12, plus k is equal to 0. 3x minus 4y plus 2 is equal to 0. So here what we will be having, we will be having this minus 18 plus k equal to 0. So k will be equal to 18. Now this value of k we will put in this equation and we will get the answer. So put k equal to 18 in equation 2. So we are having this 3x minus 4y plus 18 equal to 0. 3x minus 4y plus 18 is equal to 0. So this is the required answer. Now in question number 8. In question number 8, we are to find the equation of the line perpendicular to the given line. So perpendicular line we are given is x minus 7y. Now in the perpendicular lines, the slopes are negative reciprocal of each other. Now we are given equation of the line perpendicular to the line x minus 7y plus 5 equal to 0. This is the given line. I have to find a line which is perpendicular to this. So any line perpendicular to line 1 will be of the form, will be of the form. Now since the slopes are negative reciprocal of each other, so what we are to do, we will simply change their coefficients and then change either of the sign of x or y. So here it will be, this 1 will come to this place and this 7 will come to this place. So this will be 7x plus y. This 1 I have written in place of 7. This 7 I have written in place of 1. And then I have changed this minus sign to plus. 7x plus y plus k is equal to 0. Now I don't know the value of this constant, so let it be k. So the required equation of the line is 7x plus y plus k equal to 0, which will be perpendicular to this line. Again, we are given that this is having the x-intercept 3. Now, x-intercept 3. X-intercept 3 means this point is 3, 0. So it means that this line is passing through 3, 0. Since x-intercept is 3, therefore line 2 passes through, line 2 passes through the point 3, 0. So this 3, 0 will satisfy equation number 2. Let's put this value. This implies that 7 into 3 plus, in place of y we are having 0, 1 into 0 plus k is equal to 0. So here we are having 21 plus 0 plus k is equal to 0. It means k is equal to minus 21. So the value of k is minus 21. Now put this value in equation number 2 and you will get your answer. So put k equal to minus 21 in equation 2. So what will be the required equation? 7x plus y minus 21 equal to 0. So this will be the required equation of the perpendicular line. Now, next concept we are having, finding the angle between the two different lines. Now we are having two lines. Now if we are having two lines, naturally we will be having their slopes also, and they will be having different slopes if any angle between them is given to us. So let this be the first line and this be the second line. This one is L1, this one is L2. Slope of L1 is M1, slope of L2 is M2. I'm having two lines with slopes M1 and M2. एंड लेट द एक्यूट एंगल बिटवीन देम इज थीटा. ये एंगल मैंने ले लिया थीटा. एनी ऑफ द एंगल्स यू कैन टेक, चाहे इधर आप ले लो, ये वाला ले लो, एनी ऑफ द एंगल यू कैन टेक. सो लेट द एंगल बिटवीन देम इज थीटा. नाउ आई हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ द एंगल बिटवीन दीज टू लाइन्स. तो फॉर दैट the formula is tan theta is equal to, again since I am talking about the acute angle, so I have to use this again modulus sign. So this is m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 m2. यहाँ पे कुछ books में आपको m2 minus m1 भी मिलेगा. You can take any of the values, पहले जो मर्जी आप लिख सकते हो, because ultimately हमने उसका acute angle find out कर रहे हैं, तो modulus लेना है, तो that will be positive. So m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 m2. So this is for finding out the angle between the two given lines. So this formula will be used in your question number 9. We are given in question number 9. Find the angle between the lines root 3x plus y plus 1 equal to 0. And the second line is x plus root 3y equal to 1. X plus root 3y equal to 1. Now, for finding out the angle between the two lines, what I need? I need their slopes. Now, here I am given this line in the form root 3x plus y plus 1 equal to 0. And the second line is x plus root 3y plus this x plus root 3y equal to 1. So, first of all, I will bring this 1 to the left-hand side. So this is ax plus by plus c equal to 0 form for both. Now, I have told you earlier that whenever we are given a line and we are to find its slope, what we do? We simply, for finding out the slope, let its slope be the m1. So m1 is equal to negative sign minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. So m1 is equal to minus root 3 upon 1. Coefficient of x is root 3. Coefficient of y is 1. So negative sign we are to use. So slope of this line is minus coefficient of x, that was root 3, upon coefficient of y, that was 1. So this is minus root 3. So slope of the first line is minus root 3. Now find out the slope of the second line, m2. M2 is again negative sign, slope of x, coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. Ab mere paas m1 hai, mere paas m2 hai. Put this value in this formula for finding out the angle between the two lines. So tan theta is equal to m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 m2. So here tan theta is equal to m1 minus m2, minus root 3 minus minus 1 by root 3 upon 1 plus m1, that is minus root 3 into m2, that is again minus 1 by root 3. So this is equal to, this will get cancelled kyunki multiply ho rahe hain, dono ke aage negative sign hai, to minus into minus will become plus. So in the denominator we are having 1 plus 1. Now we are to simplify the numerator. Numerator mein here we are having root 3, here we are having 1. So you will find out the, take out the LCM, then simplify this and you, then you will get your answer. Aapki jo tan theta ki value aayegi yahan pe, tan theta you will be having as 1 by root 3 after simplifying this. Aapke paas jo value aajayegi, that will be 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 aapko pata hai, tan theta kahan pe hota hai, 30 degree pe. So your value of this theta will be 30 degree. Now let's simplify. Minus, ye root 3 hai. Yahan pe bhi minus root 3 hai. LCM aapka root 3 aa gaya. Now here, root 3 into minus root 3 is minus 3. Minus into minus is plus 1. So we are having minus 3 plus 1 by root 3 for this numerator. In the denominator, we are having this 2. Now again simplifying this further, this becomes minus 2 upon root 3 upon 2. So again you can write it down as minus 2 upon 2 root 3. This root 3 will get multiplied by this 2. Kyunki ये न्यूमिरेटर के डिनोमिनेटर में है, दिस इज ऑलरेडी इन द डिनोमिनेटर, तो ये दोनों आपके क्या हो जाएंगे, मल्टीप्लाई हो जाएंगे. सो माइनस टू एंड माइनस टू विल गेट कैंसल्ड, वी गेट द मॉड्यूलस ऑफ माइनस वन बाई रूट थ्री. व्हेन वी विल रिमूव द मॉड्यूलस साइन, वी आर हैविंग टैन थीटा इज इक्वल टू वन बाई रूट थ्री. सो थीटा इज इक्वल टू टैन थीटा आपका वन बाई रूट थ्री कहाँ पे होता है, 30 डिग्री पे. तो थीटा इज इक्वल टू we are having as 30 degree. So this was your question number 9. You will try question number 10 yourself. Question number 10 and 11 are your homework parts. You are to try these questions yourself. If any doubt is there from today's lecture, you can ask.